This is a weather briefing on the potential for severe weather this coming weekend. This briefing was created on April 24th, 2014, and is for thunderstorm potential on April 26th and 27th. There is a chance for severe storms across parts of the North and Central Texas regions Saturday and Sunday. On Saturday, severe storms are expected to develop along the dry line to the west of the region. These storms will track east and northeast, reaching the western counties of North Texas in the evening hours. There is a good chance these storms will still be severe as they move into those western counties, with a threat for large hail, damaging winds, and possibly an isolated tornado. The next slide will depict the area of concern for Saturday. Another round of severe storms is possible on Sunday, but there are several uncertainties regarding Sunday's severe weather setup. Much of the storm forecast for Sunday depends on where the dry line will be, and there is low confidence in its position at this time. However, storms that develop will likely be severe with a large hail, damaging wind, and isolated tornado threat. At this time, the greatest threat for severe storms on Sunday looks to be along and or east of the Interstate 35 corridor. On Saturday, the dry line will be west of the region across northwest Texas and the Big Country. Severe storms are likely to develop along the dry line in the late afternoon hours, tracking east and northeast into north and central Texas Saturday evening. These storms will dissipate overnight. The most likely locations to be impacted by severe storms Saturday evening and night is west of a Sherman to DFW to Killeen line. An isolated tornado will be possible during the evening hours, but the tornado threat will diminish later into the night. There are several uncertainty factors regarding Sunday's potential severe weather event, but thunderstorms are expected to develop along and east of the dry line. The main question is, where will the dry line be on Sunday? The models are showing several different positions of the dry line on Sunday, which impacts which areas could be affected by severe weather on Sunday. We have moderate to high confidence that the storms will be severe on Sunday, but low confidence on what areas will be impacted and that a significant outbreak will occur in our area. The next slide will show the potential dry line locations for Sunday. The most likely time for thunderstorm initiation along the dry line is during the afternoon hours, but could be as early as the late morning hours. Most of the consensus is that the dry line will be along the Interstate 35 corridor around midday Sunday, as depicted on possibility number one. This means that much of the eastern half of the region, including the Sherman, DFW, Waco, and Temple areas, could see severe storms and possibly tornadoes Sunday afternoon. However, it is possible that the dry line could be slightly further east, possibility number two, affecting areas mostly in East Texas, or the dry line could even be completely east of our region moving into Louisiana, possibility number three. A lesser possibility is that the dry line could stall west of the Interstate 35 corridor, possibility number four. What this would mean is that severe thunderstorms could impact a much larger portion of North and Central Texas. As noted on the slide though, the drawn positions of the dry lines are not to be taken literally, but indicate a general area for each possibility. The bottom line for Sunday is that there are several details that still need to be worked out, and everyone is urged to check back for details and updates on Sunday's forecast. This slide summarizes our confidence in the various severe weather potentials this weekend. In the red shaded area, we expect severe weather will occur Saturday evening. Storms will have the potential to produce very large hail, damaging winds, and isolated tornadoes. These storms should weaken below severe levels as they reach the Interstate 35 corridor Saturday night. The yellow and orange shaded areas will have their best chance for severe weather on Sunday afternoon and evening when a dry line moves into the area. Right now, we do not know for sure how far east the dry line will get before the severe thunderstorms develop. This means that confidence of severe weather along the I-35 corridor, as indicated by the yellow region, is lower than our confidence in the orange area. Our confidence increases that severe thunderstorms will affect eastern Texas, as indicated in the orange area, with large hail, damaging winds, and isolated tornadoes. These are a few tornado safety tips. If you are in the path of a tornado or within a tornado warning, move into a basement or interior room on the lowest floor, preferably a bathroom or a closet. Evacuate mobile homes for a storm shelter or permanent building. If no shelter is available, lie flat in the nearest ditch and cover your head. Do not stop under bridges or highway overpasses since they offer no protection from tornado winds. For severe thunderstorms in the area, if you are outside, seek shelter in a strong building and stay inside away from windows for at least 20 to 30 minutes after the storm has passed. For updates and more information, you can follow us on Twitter at NWS Fort Worth, and you can also find us on Facebook by searching for U.S. National Weather Service, Fort Worth, Texas. You can also find more information on our webpage, which is displayed there in the middle of the screen. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to email us on our webmaster account located on the bottom of the slide.